I'm Devin with a Y. I've thought about doing ASMR for a long time because I'm a pretty avid ASMR head. I'm now realizing that I still have my headphones on. So let's go ahead and take these off and trust the process. Trust the process. All right. So I think everything I do here has to be pretty careful, because it can get pretty loud, but what I'm going to be doing here is I'm going to be going through a lot of bags of film that have been developed and scanned already. I might need my phone later, so let me just put it on Do Not Disturb. Phone is on Do Not Disturb. I'll need it to probably date my film later by figuring out when I shot which role. So, okay. I'm gonna get started because I don't know how long this will take. So the reason I'm doing this at all is because it's a pretty productive thing for me to do. Shoot a lot of film last year, as in 2022. I shot 150 rolls of film, I think, and I developed them all by myself at home. It went from trying to develop the first time all the way to developing most of my work in the matter of 3 months, because I shot so much film. I shoot a lot of film. Alright, we're gonna start with medium format. So that means I need one of these sleeves. I hope that sounded nice. I feel like that would sound nice. Oh, there was this sound that I liked. Hold on 1 second. There is this sound. I like that sound. What about this one? We're learning here. Okay, so we have our sleeves ready to go. Let's get a roll of film. Let's start with this one over here. I actually have a pretty big amount, because again, I shoot a lot of film. Sleeving, you always have to check which format of 120 you do, and that determines how many frames per line you can put on in your sleeves. So 6x5, it's usually about 4. So if I put this here, see, about 4 frames will fit. So I'll cut out 4 frames at a time. Okay. I sure hope this isn't too loud. I'm trying to keep the is Cinestill 800T. And you can see here some pretty weird stuff happened. Here, my camera died. And then here, I was determined to shoot the photo fast enough for my camera not to die. You can kind of see the picture of what I was trying to take here, but yeah. This was like an everyday roll, and then... God, that's so loud. But then here, let me just put it inside the sleeves. How about that? You're pissing me off. So once it's sleeved, then we can talk more about what was shot on it. To be very careful. Actually, let me pull it here and drop it there. I like things to be ready for a contact print, even though I've never contact printed color. I'm future proofing as much work as possible. Okay, so this was Cinestill 800T, and I was biking around Tampa here. You can see this is the Hillsborough River in Tampa. This is like a water taxi, some kayakers. This is probably the best photo here. This one right here. This one right here. I'll show that one. And then the rest of them are kind of okay. The clouds one is pretty good. And then maybe I'll show this one of the photo I was trying to get with my vintage mirror on the grass. And then this is water cooler studio. Okay. So let's work on sleeving first. And then we'll start dating. Already, oh my gosh. We're sticking with 120 right now, and that's all 35. Ooh, I think this is a roll. Simple here. Oh my gosh. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3. Okay. All right. So let's cut 3 from the back. a roll of 400D. This was kind of an everyday roll. I wasn't shooting anything specific with it. It's really interesting getting to see the photos I took on this given day, because I can tell you what I was doing during all of them. This was after a Blue Angel show, because we went to get food somewhere, and then I saw the Waffle House from a distance. This was with my friend Sierra. We were planning an event, and I was taking a few portraits of her. This was at that park that I can't really tell based on the negative. Oh, I was walking around the neighborhood where I live. This is a church around the neighborhood where I live. This is Ybor. I did a bike ride before. For these three pictures. Those are really good photos. This, I was doing a walk with Steven, my friend Steven from Coastal Film Lab, and I was taking pictures. And I guess that's all three of these are, because I saw this on the Weasel. I took this getting in the car after shooting with Steven. That's cool. Good video. This was a mistake. I think that's that corner of the room, which is funny. And this is my grandma feeding my little brother. But I took that photo again. So it survived. I don't know. Kind of a mess, to be honest. But let's get it done. Gosh. Why does that have to be so loud? Stop being so loud. this was a fun roll. Or you can just be loud as hell. Goodness gracious. Let me put this like this. Think it'll. That will help me cut. Okay. 1, 2. Why is the spacing on this so small? Satisfying. This is a roll of Lomo 800. That was also kind of an everyday film. An everyday roll for me. Got a lot of good stuff. I actually got some stuff from the event that my friend and I were planning. Stage and then the execution stage on two different rolls of film. This is that event right here. This is a great photo. Very happy with it. And then this is that event we were playing or planning. This is the Bubble Bebop. Bubble Bebop. Bubble Bebop. Lots of cool stuff. This is my Uncle Ray at a pizza place. This is a vintage still life shoot. Me and a couple friends did. This is a stranger and his dog at that pizza place, Hampton Station. And then this is my dog, Hila. Love her to death. Alright. Let's see if we can wrap up the 120 year. I think that's the end of it. Yep, this is the last of the 120. But I think there's two rules here. Oh, maybe not. Oh, actually, I think there are. I don't know. I can't tell. I usually don't let my film stockpile as much. It's kind of funny, actually. Because I love doing this part, so I usually do it very quickly. Okay, this is a good roll. This is part of my pet project that I've actually posted a couple shorts about on YouTube. So, maybe you've seen it, I don't know. I forget. Can I do three here, or do I have to do twos? Right? I don't know. I haven't shot 6-7 in a long time. There's three fit. Three fits, right? One, two, three. It like barely fits three. Okay. I guess we're doing threes from the front though. I'll do two threes and two twos. Yeah, that's what I do. I'll do this too, because the spacing here is big. For some reason, I'll do two twos and two threes. Two. project that I'm calling My Friend's Friends, where I go to people's houses or wherever they are most comfortable with, and then I take portraits of them with their pets. It's mostly been dogs, but I've gotten a couple where they have reptiles or frogs or chickens or something like that. And that's a very, very rewarding project so far. I've shot about, I think, 13 subjects now. But this role in specific was of my friend Ivana and her dog Frida. They actually just moved to New York, like, literally yesterday. But this role of film was very special to me because I grew very close to them, and I actually asked to use her camera for it, because that was also a point of our friendship where I borrowed her camera and she borrowed mine and kind of traveled the world with it. I didn't travel the world, but I did travel a little bit with it, I think. So, yeah. These are also pretty. So I'm doing headshots of everyone in the project, and then I get photos of them together when they actually spend time together and stuff. It's nice. Alright, let's wrap this up by naming and dating and organizing them. I have a few minutes. Okay, let's see. So, what day was this? It was like last week. So I always take photos of the things I'm taking photos of. And the main reason for that is so that I can, one, make content out of it, but then two, so that I can reference it and have a date on it. So right here, I'm checking my phone, and it looks like I took these photos on... When did I take these photos? Was it before this or after this? I don't remember. Shoot. Come on. Actually, don't. Oh, there we go. April 28th. Film, I think, right? Yeah. This is RC67 Pro 2, and then P100. Alright, next. I'm gonna put this over. Chill out. Jeez. I'll just put that right there for now. Okay. Come on. This is... I'll just say... EDZ... / BTS. This is... Lomo. Oops. Camera. Let's see. Yeah, I just Yashika. Jeez. is at 1.24G. I feel like I'm ripping this sheet to shreds. And then 200. Eight recording limits. Okay. This roll of film is so chaotic. I'll just do EDC again. EDC. Matt 124. I don't even have to do Matt. And then HB 5. Didn't date the last one. I'm also not going to date this one. This one. Second, pretty sure. Yes, it was 4:22. April 5th or something. No, that was April. Close. Come on. Get me there, get me there, get me there. Or maybe it was earlier. Yeah, April 2nd. I should number my files. Too bad. I keep forgetting this camera's there. That's something I want to improve on the next one. Okay. So it was Tampa Bike. Solo. This is 800T. And the date of this, oof. That's a tough one. I might have to go to my map on Google Photos for this one. Hello, Google Photos. Okay, so then I go to here, and then my map. Remember where it was when I took these, so then I go and my Tampa. It's by the water. Wait. I'm lost right now. Hold on. I'm over here. Okay, there we go. So then it was over here at this bridge. Right here. Nice. And so it was April 5th. So 4-5. 4-5-23. Alright. And that's gonna do it for this episode. I don't know. I had a good time. It took a lot longer than I thought, but that's okay. I'm gonna do more of these because they're productive and relaxing and fun. I hope it wasn't too loud. If it was, I'll figure it out in editing. Follow me on Instagram, it's Devin with a Y, and subscribe and, I guess, comment and tell me if this is any good here on YouTube. So, thank you.